Sunland Apple IPTV Entertainment Perfected Faces Candy. Practical ways to change your thinking and change your life. Importance of mindset work. There's great importance in spending time doing mindset work. Within this period, we begin to understand ourselves, and through that understanding, we become more compassionate and patient with ourselves. Our society and culture thrive on the busyness that life brings not only into our lives but even to our dinner table. With that comes some consequences of using band-aid solutions and quick remedies to get through particular blocks in our lives. Those solutions never last long, and it's about committing the time and effort to slow down, ground ourselves, and reshift our focus. Changing your thinking is not only to be more optimistic but giving your mind the breathing room it needs to grow and expand. It's about looking at everything that hasn't worked for you and being open to other ways that might.
You say, well, Billy, what really do I have to do? First, you have to be willing to repent of your sin. You say, well, what does that mean? That means to change your way of living, to change your thinking about Christ and about God and about yourself. It means to live a new kind of a life. It means that you're willing to give up some of those wrong things in your life and walk with Him. That's repentance. And Jesus said, except a man repent, he can't see the kingdom of God. Have you repented? Are you sure of it? Did that change take place? I'm not talking about, did you say, oh Lord, I'm sorry. That's not repentance. Oh Lord, I've sinned. That's not repentance. It means a change. All things have passed away and everything becomes new. And then the second thing, you must receive Him by faith. But as many as received Him, to them gave He power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on His name. Just simple faith.
God will find you. Sunland Apple IPTV Entertainment Perfected Faces, done by Candy.
See, I didn't find God in the church. In fact, I didn't find God at all. He found me. He met me in a place where I was so broken, I couldn't get up. And when you're loved like that, it will shock you.
Whoever needs to hear this, listen now. God did not bring you this far to leave you. He did not bring you this far to... The scripture says that he that started a good work, he starts a good work, he's faithful to see it through till the end. The work that the Lord has started in you is a good work, and He will surely see it through to the end. He says He makes all things work together for good for those that love the Lord and are called according to His purpose. You did not find God, contrary to the way it explained today that, oh, I found God. You did not find God. God was not lost. You was lost. God found you. And so if He finds you, He is big enough, strong enough and able enough to secure you and to keep you. Got to believe that. In the book of Matthew's chapter 6 verse 44, it says, no one can come to you unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up at the last day. Christ is saying that if the Father did not send you, if the Father did not send you to Him, you will not be able to know Him. So God found you. So you've got to believe that if He found you and He's brought you this far, then He's faithful enough, He's able enough, and He's more than willing to see you through to the very end, because He does a good work. He doesn't do unfinished business. No. The Lord finishes His work perfectly. The book of Ephesians 2 verses 10 says that we are God's masterpiece. Listen to these words: created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared for us a long time ago. So before you were even born, there was a preparation for you. You've got to believe that, because it's true. Before you even says, before you were formed in your mother's womb, I knew you, I'd set you apart, right? So there's a preparation for you, there's a plan for you, there's a purpose for you, there's a path for you. And you are a masterpiece that is going through to perfection. You will be perfected. You're going through a process that is going to take you to perfection. The Lord did not bring you this far to leave.
God wants to be pursued. He's a relational God. He's a jealous God. He wants your heart. He wants your devotion. He wants your passion. In fact, he gives us an incredible promise in Jeremiah 29, verse 13. He says this, God says, you will seek me. And what happens when you seek me? When you seek me, he says, you'll find me. It's a promise. If you pursue God, he will reveal himself to you. You will seek me and find me. When you seek me with all your heart, God says, I will be found by you, declares the Lord. When you draw near to him, when you pursue him, when you crave him, when you hunger for him, God loves to be pursued and he loves to reveal himself to you.
To speak to people about a peg. So when you look at a peg, Mr. Lerato, there's this silver spring in the center.
Yes.
A peg cannot function without the silver spring in the center. If I remove the silver spring in the center, it'll be just two pieces of planks that mean nothing. Same thing with your life. If I remove God at the center of your heart, you'll be a meaningless person. You wouldn't know your purpose. You wouldn't know your calling. You wouldn't know who you are. Number two, when you hang clothes on a line, why do you put a peg? You put a peg so that impacts a zinga or zinga gold. Same thing with your life. Why do you receive God in your life? You receive God so that you don't fall into depression, anger, anxiety, bitterness, jealousy. That is why you need God in your life, so that you can be who you are and know your identity and purpose. Number three, if I remove the clothes from the pegs, impahla zonzakala zizohole. So that is why it's very important to stick onto the Lord. Number four, Apex does not discriminate, Sisley Rad. It doesn't matter whether you are rich, whether you are poor, whether you are filthy, whether you are dirty. Apex's job is to hold you back. It does not matter who you are. Apex is going to hold you. Isn't this the same thing that God says, come as you are? It doesn't matter how broken, it doesn't matter what happened in your life. God is saying that just come as you are. Right now, during this lockdown, there's somebody that's broken. It's saying that, I have no future. There's no hope, Bongan. But I want to tell you, God is saying, come as you are. And the word fear, Sisley Rato, the word fear, this word, fear, it has two meanings for me, Sisley Rato. It says, first meaning is from the enemy. And people will say, forget everything and run away from the promises that God has for you. It's saying forget. But I want you to turn it around today. I don't care what situation you're facing today. Turn it around. Face everything and rise. I don't care what situation you've been through. A lot of people, they might have thrown stones. Like, dogs do not bark at a car that stands still, but dogs bark at a car that's moving. So what I'm telling you, run, hustle. It's difficult. Today I'm an author, Sisley Rato. My friends, when I shut my
in the mirror lately, wish you could trade eyes with me. There's complexities in complexion, but your skin is glow like diamonds. Dig me like the earth, you be giving birth to everything alive, baby, know your worth. I love everything about you, from your nappy curls to every single curve, your body natural. Same skin that was broken, be the same skin taking over. Most things are to focus you, but when you're in the room, they notice you. Tells your story. Keep dancing, they can't control you. They watching it.